Hi, everyone. My name is Patrick Salyer, CEO of Gigya. And just as background, Gigya makes websites social. So we provide online businesses a suite of social application, and it's built on a unified API infrastructure. We connect businesses to Facebook Connect, Twitter Connect, LinkedIn Connect, and 20 other Connect-style APIs. To give you a sense of scale, we have hundreds of clients. For example, 7 of the top 10 media companies use Gigya. So NBC, CBS, Fox, ABC, top brands like Coca-Cola, Pepsi. You've interacted with us, you just haven't known it. We're kind of the social plumbing behind the scenes. So, but today's about APIs, right? And Gigya is about social APIs. That's where we focus. So I thought I would start by getting real old school, right? Where did social identity APIs begin? And show of hands, anyone in this room remember Microsoft Passport? There's a couple, yeah, some, all right. Well, you guys probably used that to log into Prodigy, didn't you? Right? Da-dum-dum. All right, so we all know Microsoft Prodigy didn't make it, right? We could argue why or why not, but long story short, it didn't get the adoption it needed, came out years ago. It wasn't until 2007 that I think we really had another Connect style, another social identity API come to the market. We all know what that was, right? Facebook Connect with the Facebook Connect API. And I think it's interesting just to take a second and think about why did that work, right? What was the equation that got mass adoption for the Facebook Connect API? And I think it came down to incentives, right? User incentives, publisher incentives. And I think it's important as we think about APIs, what can get these things adoption? Now, Facebook figured out that why did users want to use it? It was pretty simple for them, right? Users wanted to be social. They wanted to go to TripAdvisor, and it was more interesting to see what their friends were doing than just random strangers. So that's pretty simple. But I think the really important piece was they added value to publishers, right? And so for publishers, publishers want money. They want ROI. That's how they make money. So they figured out, number one, publishers want traffic. And Facebook found a great way to get those publishers' traffic through the newsfeed. And this is a chart here. This blue bar is for these various sites, referral traffic from Facebook. And the green bar is traditional traffic from Google, right? Traditional SEO traffic. And the fact that many of these sites get more traffic from Facebook than Google was a pretty big deal, right? So this was the first big piece of the equation. I'd say the second piece of value Facebook figured out was data. So they gave access to this incredibly rich data set, interests, likes, activities, other extremely rich data. It took them a while to figure that out. I don't know if you remember, but at first they had a rule where you could only cache data, store it for 24 hours, but they lifted that and it really helped with the adoption pretty dramatically. So we get it, right? Facebook made it mass adoption, but others came on the scene, right? You had Twitter with their Twitter Connect API. Then you had LinkedIn, LinkedIn Connect API. Viadeo, obviously that's why we're here today, another API. Google Plus, they're going to come out with their API. But internationally, there's a whole lot of APIs, right? So publishers need to adopt these. They're becoming necessary for every site, but it's a headache, right? These APIs are built on different standards often, the OAuth standard, OpenID, OAuth Wrap, OAuth 1, OAuth 2, et cetera, et cetera. They change a lot. Facebook will have a change about once a month that will break code. Who knows what's coming up next? It's a pain. That's where Gigya comes in. We simplify all this. So we like to think we invented the super social API. We provide a single API that sites can implement, and on the back end, we're connecting to Facebook Connect, Twitter Connect, LinkedIn Connect, and anything else that comes out. So think of it, implement once, get many, forget about the changes. We just make it very, very easy. Just so you know, on top of that, that's about our infrastructure, right? But on top of that, we have built applications. We call them plugins, the most common social functionality that sites are implementing. And we take utilities that sites already have, right? Like comments is a great example. But for us, we really believe that identity will rule the web. Identity will be a central part of every site. So we incorporate identity into every single utility that we provide. So comments, right? Comments for us are social comments. The real photo, then the real name of the individual. The ability to syndicate that comment to a user's friends. The ability to see what your friends are commenting on as well. So social integration into each one of these applications. We provide game mechanics, ratings and reviews, reactions. You've seen these on the web. You just didn't know it was Gigya providing it. All right. So that's Gigya. running out of time. That's Gigya today. Looking forward, again, we talked about login will rule the web. We think there'll be pretty interesting integrations involving social graph data, identity data, and interest graph data. You're seeing sites like Amazon test some of this stuff, so it'll be interesting to see kind of where this goes. Thank you. Look forward to your questions.
Great. Thank you, Patrick. My first question is somewhat coy, but was that PowerPoint or Keynote?
That was PowerPoint.
Okay. Hands up. For just Josh and you. Question.
If I'm looking to launch a social network site or build an API, some sort of identity API, does Gigya have any sort of standard that I can follow to make it more interoperable and work with Gigya and others?
So we've integrated any and all standards. If you adhere to kind of the OAuth 2, that seems to be the standard that a lot of the social networks are adhering to. But the short answer is no, but if I had to pick one, OAuth 2.
How about open social?
Sure. So is that Kevin Marks? You could probably come up here and speak better about all of these issues than I can. So this is one of the guys that basically helped create all of these standards.
Okay, this guy. Since Kevin cut me off, Kevin, you owe me a drink. With regards to quality of traffic, so you're able to show the referring traffic coming from wherever real estate that's being driven. Are you able to qualify what was an article or an ad or some type? What was the relevancy or caused them to come to the website? So whether it was they saw a banner or they saw content or read something,
sure,
to show instead of just general traffic that what it was.
Yeah, great question. So the answer is yes. And what we're doing is we can measure someone shares X piece of content. So they're looking at a product page on an e-commerce site, and they share that they just bought this product. We can measure how many people came out of Facebook and Twitter, and we can also measure if they bought something. So a recent retailer that implemented Giant Nerd saw that every share to Facebook was worth something like $4 or $5 a share. So we're able to track at that level. Good question.
You guys raise your hands up high. Don't be shy, folks. This is a great opportunity. Seriously, if you have even a stupid question, that's good.
There's no such thing as a stupid question.
I know. In the back.
There we go.
John Adams, Twitter.
Hey, how you doing?
Great.
You already said it for me. A question for you. So I think that this seems to be like an overlay layer into normal like authorization and identity management on the web. Do you participate in open programs such as Open Social or Open ID? Because that seems like a better solution to this problem rather than an overlay layer.
So I fully believe some of those standards may eventually emerge, and we're part of those discussions. So we're speaking at the OpenID Connect conference next week. And that's, for us, that's fine. We're building more and more applications, value-added applications that sit on top of that layer. That layer could eventually become commoditized. It isn't yet. But social login, again, is probably one-tenth of what we do, getting the game mechanics, comments, other functionality like that. Great.
Okay. Anybody else? Don't be shy.
Here we go, in the back.
Hey, just curious if you could speak to your competition and the companies you do work with, 7 of the top 10 media companies. Can they use your service and your competitor service at the same time, or do they have to choose?
Sure. So in terms of, we're pretty unique in taking the suite approach. So we, as you saw on that screen, we do social login, sharing, comments, game mechanics, ratings, and reviews. Basically, anything a site needs to be social. There are competitors that do, we essentially consider them point solutions, so they'll do one of those different use cases. When we work with clients, they tend to buy the whole suite, right? That's our value proposition. Everything syncs together. You don't have to do additional coding, same code set, same analytics, et cetera, et cetera. That being said, we do have cases where we partner with some of the different point solutions if our customer chose that.
Any other questions? Did somebody ask how you make a living, how you make money?
I don't believe that's been asked, but that's important to me. We're software as a service, so we license our technology, very, very simple. Flat annual licensing fee.
What's this starting fee?
Starting around $25,000 annually.
Oh my gosh.
I like that.
You can ask my wife.
I think I know what she might say.
Oh no.
Hey, he's a social guy. Patrick, thank you so much. Gigya, everybody.